Hi, welcome. I'm Reverend Allie Bierman, and this is Metaphysical Ministry International. I'm so glad you joined me here today. Oh, it's a metaphysical ministry. What goes on in the world is way more than what you can notice, experience, using only your five senses. Because you see, your five senses can only detect what you can see, hear, taste, smell, touch. That's less than 1% of what really exists in the world. So you want to be metaphysical, go beyond what you can physically experience to really get a full experience of what life is all about. We begin every week with a happy share. I have a lot of happy shares, which you will too as soon as you start doing it. Something that leaves you feeling good, feeling happy, something for you. Well, I was at a service this morning. I like to go to different services, and today I was at one for Science of Mind, and I saw somebody who I haven't seen in years, and pretty much everybody knows that I had brain surgery 8 months ago, and he asked me how I was doing, and I said, well, I'm not how I used to be, and he said, that's because you're better than before. And he got me thinking of the ways that I can be better than before because of how I am now, which sure doesn't feel better most of the time. But you know, I know everything happens for a reason. So I'm really happy that he just put that in my face and let me come to a place of really getting what it's all about. And to that end, I get to be the minstrel minister today, and I wrote a song about that. I haven't sung in over 8 months, so let's see what happens. Don't focus on what you can't, just notice what it can do in a new way. Different is good, never let anybody tell you how you should live your life. How to turn around all strife, create a new view. How you live each moment is up to you. Everything in life happens perfectly. Open your heart to clearly see the fact that you're better than before, better today than yesterday. Not letting limitations block your way. To love, to joy, 'cause everything in life is all about you and your point of view. Okay, everything in life is totally about how you're looking at your life, and you are creating from in here the world that you're experiencing out there. You know what? So my singing isn't totally back yet. So I sang it in a new way today, but I did it. What is it that you haven't been doing because you've been afraid you can't do it quite the way you used to be able to do it? Or maybe you've done it, not done it before. Step out of your comfort zone. You never know what you can do until you go ahead and do it. Now, I didn't say try to do it, because you either do it or you don't. You may not have the outcome that you were hoping for, but you're still having an outcome that you would not have had if you didn't step out and make an effort. Take a step in a new direction, because if you keep doing the same thing you've been doing, well, I guess we all know that's the definition of insanity. Now, last week, I told you that I'd show you something to do, really simple, with a hanger. So I took this hanger, I'm going to come in a little closer, and I cut it into these shapes so I can put it in my hands and it's freely moving. Okay? What's making it move? It's not the wind. What's making it move is what I'm thinking. Now, because something went on with my brain, this is a really important thing for me to do. I usually use this as a demonstration of how you control what's going on in your life with your brain, which produces very, very real electrical impulses and energy that go out in the world, your brain and your mind. So what I'm doing with these is I have a garden over that way, and I'm going to think about them pointing to the garden. Okay, so what happened in the surgery? Oh dear, now that. I haven't done this in a couple of days. It's something I need to do every day. So you can see what's in my left hand, it's pointing exactly at the garden. What's in my right hand went past the garden, it's pointing to me. The surgery impacted, even though it was on the right side of my brain and brainstem, it impacted the skull bones on my left side, which controls my right hand. So what I need to work on is rebuilding the connections that are being impacted by that skull bone being out of place. And the more I think, point to the garden. I hope you can easily see. Now they're both pointing to the garden. But this one didn't go there instantly, like the left one coming out of my right brain. Interesting. Surgery was on the right side of my brain, and yet it's the left brain that I'm having to develop because the skull bone's still out of place. I could tell you more about that as a specialized kinesiologist, but that's not why I'm here right now. Right now, I want you to know this is an exercise to do to control what you're focusing on. You're focusing your energy. You're using your mind to put the thought into your brain, where then the brain chemicals can control. Oh, there I go again. I have a lot of work to do, don't I? At least I know how to do it. If you look up at the top of the page on the ministry site, you will see a page, Hold a Space For. Holding a space for is sharing in someone's vision for something they want to create in their world. It might be a new home. It might be taking a course that they really want, that they don't know that it exists, or it exists someplace far away. They really, really want to do it. So when we hold the vision of seeing them doing it, that makes that thought form bigger. And the bigger the thought form going out to the universe, the sooner and more likely it is to actually become manifest in that person's life. So when you put down what it is you want us to hold the space for, just scroll down, leave it in the comments, and I will add it also up on that page. Come back at least once a week and tell everyone you know to do the same, because the more people who just look at your name, you don't have to read it out loud, just think it inside and think of this person doing it. You don't have to know the person. You have a name, you have what they want to make real in their lives. What is it you want to make real in your life? Please scroll down. Let us know how you're doing in your life every day. And do cut up a hanger and start controlling what's going on with your mind. You will see a difference. You will see a difference in your brain functioning. You will see a difference in your clarity. Thank you again for joining me here today. I wish you a very blessed week.